Hey everybody, Invisible Katana here, back again with Resident Evil Revelations 2. As you guys can see, I just decided to already have it loading up, and I realized, after I did the last episode, I checked, and I actually will be able to start up exactly where I left off, so we won't be starting over the entire story. Pick up right here.
You must be ready to snap by now.
Which is actually
I won't stop until I find Lottie. There are lots of monsters this way. Maybe you can hide in the grass. I'll try.
And duck. So I was really excited to see that I actually got to start right here, and well, that's game, or not? Oh crap! Or we'll just see what happens here. I love this though. It's like la da 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 da. Really love the fact that he just totally pushed me right out of the way there. As long as it works, who cares? Okay. Felt like I was being a little reckless there, because I, of course, don't know if other monsters are just gonna randomly be spawning, or what the case is, or if I somehow actually missed that thing when I went through last time, which I just refuse to believe. I ran right past it and missed it, and then, you know, I was just oblivious that it had even existed that whole time. But it's possible. Who knows? Very unlikely, though, because they do, you know, the whole glowing thing, pretty hard to miss. Interesting. I think that may have just been a little taste. Like, that's the first one, and then we're gonna get our next portion where it's gonna be a bunch of other ones. Forgot to set my little timer. It's right in the way. Although, I guess now it is good to know that she, if I switch to her, apparently there's just zero danger for regular Natalia. Oh, okay. So, that is really good to know. That makes it, jeez. Every time she does that.
Do the looking now. This me control. I don't want your help. I can find her myself.
Okay, that's what I thought. Alright, so, stupid invisibugs. There we are. So that's one. Maybe just the one. I don't know why that actually freaked me out. Let's go back and forth. It moves fairly slow. Should be able to get past it. Sweet. Okay. Easy enough. Once again, it's like one with the regular, one with the invisible, and then odds are the next little segment's gonna have both. If I'm so close, I can barely tell because it gets so distorted, I can't really tell the path. Alright. So, do this. So, wait till it goes back, then. Actually, I'm gonna check that first before I just run over. Like, I can easily hide here. Okay, I can. I'll probably wait till the next one. I didn't want to take that chance, like, oh, I can hide there because it looks like I can. And then, of course, it gets me. So it turns around. Duck in here. Can't really see it too well. I probably could have made that, actually. Because they tend to have very straightforward myself up. Oh, no, okay. It didn't have very straightforward vision. I probably could have just ran right past it and, you know, kept going.
Do you want to rest? I know this can't be easy.
I won't give up.
See, I'm starting to wonder if that's on purpose now. If it's really... If they make it where both their mouths move at the same time on purpose. Hey, it's the tower. I'm like, no, it's weird. It's too weird over here. Something's off. Yep. Alright, so, and there it is. One invisible and one regular, of course. And I'm assuming I have to get past this guy, get in there. I forgot she could actually run. Let's see. Oh no, I can't do that. Nope. That's weird that the ladder is on the inside of that. That's really weird to me. But I guess it's just to let people know, no need, don't go up there. And I think... I could definitely be wrong, but I feel like this is the first time this specific section has actually been in gameplay. But I'm pretty sure that's wrong. I know I've been in that room before. Like, in the first chapter, you're in that room. But I don't think this specific chunk is in there where you actually see the tower. And this could be a different tower, but I assume it's the same one that Claire was on in the beginning. I didn't realize that it went all the way over there. Oh, it just goes all the way around. I hope. Okay. And then that's obviously just gonna stand there looking straight ahead like nothing's happening, so. No real issues. I really can't tell where it's at. It's just... Man. Okay. Make it easy on myself. I'll just put her in front of it and I'll see exactly where it pushes her. And we'll know where it's going.
There's nowhere else to look. Poor Lottie. You never found her. No one asked you. I'm not losing her like I lost my mom and dad. Is she that important to you? You've gone crazy, Natalia. I'm not crazy. I just don't want to be alone anymore. I don't want to be sad.
I can take that sadness away if you let me in.
You just have to trust me.
I don't know you. You're not me at all. I want Lottie. Why won't you make this easy?
All right, so they were doing the forced kind of slow down thing right there. So that's why I figured I'd switch. Suspicious. Nothing? No. Okay. Every time it's like the long stretch to get the note, it's like that just looks too open. It's like a super long path. It's like there's just... It's
Lottie,
suspicious. And also, her mouth was not moving when Dark Natalia was talking, so that definitely was just a weird glitch that they did.
Lottie.
Which, I figured. It's like, it would have been awesome.
Natalia, I don't think I can go on any longer. You'll find what's left of me.
Oh.
On the beach.
And this is how she runs into Barry.
I'm coming for you, Lottie.
I didn't even consider how this would end and where it would even end at. I didn't even think of that as part of the story. I was just thinking it's just in between and, it, you know, that's it. But that's interesting. Oh, and this is also the end. So I guess that means she decided to let her darker side in, and that's when she was able to gain those abilities and It was a blend of both sides of her, where the monsters, of course, attack her if they see her, but she could sense the monsters.
Gosh-a-rooney, you little bitch! I'm supposed to win this game of tug-of-war!
I don't even know what's happening now, but that was funny. And now it's dead. Okay, even funnier. To me, at least.
But there's still plenty of time to get under your skin.
And next time, you won't see me coming.
Super confused now, because I don't understand how that lasted for so long.
I'm here, baby.
Yeah.
Please be alive.
Okay. S again for Stylish. Super Bounty Hunter. Cool. Lottie fractured. And I'm not scared. Alright, so that was the Little Miss bonus segment. That's a cool little still of her. Creepy, but, you know, nice little aesthetic. That was cool. I like that one. I think I enjoyed both campaigns. Both the extra campaigns. I think I liked the Little Miss one better just because it was different. And so was the struggle because of the way it played out. But for the most part, it was exactly the same. It was just that one section where it was like you can't fight the monsters. Because they're so strong. Other than that, which was super creepy, and it was, you know, it's mostly the reason I lost the first time I went through that one. Aside from that, it was fairly normal. It was like, you know, collect the rabbits in the first one, you fight a couple of monsters in that one. The second one is straight up monsters in survival, which was really fun because they don't have that type of moment in the game. Not well, they kind of do, just from generally how the game was created. There are tons of segments where they're just a bunch of monsters, but that was one of them where it was clearly just monsters and monsters and monsters. But I did enjoy that, and we're gonna get into raid mode, but I like, oh okay, that's fine. Now I am curious, so I'm gonna go turn the internet on super super quick. I didn't know that they actually.
Rise and shine, my adorable little guinea pig. This is my baby, the Red Queen Alpha. I've invested a lot of time into making this the perfect battle simulator. And now it's time for you to show me what it can do. Run, my little hairball. Spin those wheels.
Interesting. I was not expecting this to be like this whatsoever. I thought for sure that this was just going to be like everything else. Okay, so I do get to pick my characters though. It still starts off very interesting. I didn't know that it was going to have like this weird little story mode type deal, which is very interesting. Trying to figure out what the heck these numbers mean. This is super confused. Oh, Wesker. And Hunk. Can't hate Hunk, but I think I'm gonna go with Milady Claire. Keep it simple. Why not change the costume? I've done all the normal costumes. Oh, we actually get to see what they do. I'm sure it's not too difficult to note that there is jiggle, like instantaneous jiggle, which is like, okay, well, not a surprise there. Oh, really? Alright, these are weird. This is just like, considering the cowgirl outfit, I think I have to do that. I don't know what it is with gestures in video games now. That is a lunatic thumbs up. Come in there. This is really weird. How is that a giddy schoolgirl? That just looked weird. Hip hop dance. Ooh. That is the most seizure-ific robot I've ever seen in my life. Once again, cowgirl outfit, so let's do that. Even though none of this is useful at all. Let's go this. Because if I have options. I'm assuming these numbers and locks are other levels, which is insane. But we'll see. We'll see what I get. Alright, let's do this. What does it say? Oh. Her shirt says lose or live. Okay. So don't defeat the enemies. This is very interesting. I really didn't think that this was the way raid mode played out, because I thought raid mode was really just gonna be like a lot like mercenaries mode, really. I just assume it's mercenaries mode. It does have the mercenaries theme. This is like the actual music from Resident Evil 6 that they have in there, which is pretty cool. And I know that they have like those green things for extra time. Boom. This cowgirl outfit looks really weird on her. It would be really awesome if... This is Resident Evil 6. This is the level from... Yeah. That's actually really awesome. This is the level. This is like the opening level for Jake and Sherry's campaign from Resident Evil 6. Oh, he can see me. He's looking at me. Whoops. That is actually very cool. No, that's not that. Ah, messed that up big time. Okay, nothing. Whoopsie. This is actually very cool. I never would have thought that raid mode would be the actual levels from Resident Evil 6. That's actually pretty amazing. Because these did come out very close together. Revelations 2 and 6. But that is super cool. It would have been awesome if they had this and... dang. Thought I could have hit them both. Getting my buttons. There it is. No. Right. It seems like they took out the sort of impact that they have on each other. Right, I'm gonna explore this, so I'm gonna go a little bit further instead of scared the crap out of me. I guess that just means this section is done. Yeah. Mm. only thing missing are just a bunch of freaking missiles coming out of the sky. I haven't played 6 in quite a while. I'm definitely gonna have to do that for sure. Man. Now I'm excited to go through the rest of Raid Mode because I want to know what other levels from the game they put in here. Maybe it's like the first level of every campaign. Except for maybe Ada's, because Ada's was like kind of the secret campaign a little bit. Let's see what else is down this way. Nothing. Also, this is actually cool for a second reason, because you don't actually get to explore this area and really like enjoy it aesthetically, because there are like missiles raining from the sky during this part of the game when you play it. So this is actually cool and a totally new experience as well, because you actually get to look at everything. You get to see the sights of the mountain range and stuff across, which looks a little weird. It looks like cardboard cutouts, and I guess it's just because, you know, obviously it's not gonna have as much detail, but it's like it's detailed in a really odd way. Oh, okay. I'm like, how did they get up there, like, or get up to me? Because I'm like, I'm assuming they have to be a challenge, but I see now. See, they kind of got rid of that, which kind of sucks. Not close enough. Oops. Yeah, see, like right next to each other, and nothing. Like, they still don't, you know, knock each other down. That kind of is, admittedly, because that's a big thing now, considering what they've done with the games. Yeah, they've made them, a lot more action-oriented, so they have all these segments and stuff where, you know, you can do stuff like that, where you kick an enemy, you knock two enemies down and stuff, and they don't have it in this game, of course. What's that? Bing. That. So stage one, super simple, pretty fun. Well, okay guys, let's ooh, an ice bottle. I don't think I've ever had that. They're not really congregating like I wanted them to. Alright. Let's do this the old fashioned way then. Camera back on. Oh, I thought he was gonna swing. Thought I had a little bit more time. So now I'm gonna be rude and just take him out with a knife. Or kick too, I guess. Also acceptable. Ah, it's a pretty cool coin. I actually really like the effects on this coin. It actually looks very nice with the 3D effect on it. That's actually really cool. Alright. Challenge medallion. Not overload the recommended model. So some of those some of those clearly you get automatically for doing the first level. Like, I guess technically the one without an herb isn't necessarily true. I mean, if you aren't, you know, really that good at it, I guess you could need the herb. Although I don't think, I don't know. Raid Mode Gesture, yay. So I don't know if certain people probably did have to use a green herb, if there were even herbs in that level, so I think it's kind of like you can't get one. You won't be able to use the unevaluated items, albums, that you find in treasure boxes. You have to spend the gold coins to evaluate them at the item evaluation screen, the vestibule's jukebox, in order to use them. The more useful the item is, the more gold coins it will take to evaluate it. So you can use that as a way to judge whether or not it's an item worth evaluating. Does that make sense? Evaluate. Okay. Well, that makes sense. First the handgun and then... excuse me, magnum and then shotgun, which of course I'm gonna get myself a shotgun because I love me a good shotgun. So, jamming. Weapon upgrading. You can attach custom parts to your weapon at the workbench. Unlike the campaign, it's not easy to remove the parts you have attached. You must choose to either destroy the part to remove it or destroy the weapon itself and collect the remaining parts. Take care in deciding what parts you want to attach. That's very interesting. You cannot equip two of the same parts, such as damage level 1 and damage level 2, at the same time. The following part combinations are also prohibited: burst plus 1, 2, and full burst, fire ammo, ice ammo, electric ammo, which would be awesome, which also isn't in the game, unless I totally miss those items in the game with the fire ammo, just like the ice bomb, not in the campaign, unless I completely missed it. Extended burn, frostbite, electrocute, just, you know, elemental damage, charge, mundane, murderer, and elite killer, close range, long range, focus, and scatter, which is funny because those are totally opposite, so it gives you, oh, capacity's 2? Naturally. Well, I didn't use the machine gun, so I'm trying to think. Maybe that's why I wasn't picking up machine gun ammo, because everything was handgun ammo. So I would assume that it was because I was only using the handgun during that time. But I will definitely wait. Yeah, I'm going to wait and stick with what I've got. Oh. That's just cool. Jamin, Vitamin Album, Saw I Conquered, Clear One Gauntlet, Acquire One Skill, Voice Log. Oh.
Rise and shine? Ooh, that's the spirit, lab rat. Your vitals are stable as well.
This is a tall, creepy, weird room. I like this. This is definitely not what I was expecting for raid mode. I really thought it would just be like mercenaries mode. You just go in, you pick a character, and you get points. And I'm trying to remember. I may not have actually even played raid mode during Revelations 1. I'm pretty sure I did, like once or twice maybe. Increase myself to 1,200 points. So sweet. Where are we going? 5 skill points. I don't know what my health points are, but that definitely seems like a skill worth having. I'll just equip it for now. So level 5, I get another one. Level 8. Oh, level 5, I get... Oh no, that's totally different. Level 5, I'll also get another skill. Then level 13, I'll get another special weapon type. And we'll go from there, I guess. We will definitely change costume. Go back to normal. It'd be cool if you could actually rotate the costume to just look at it while you're selecting. I want the shotgun, but that just guarantees more ammo. At least from the start, it does. So I think I will stick with that for now. And we will continue on with Miss Redfield. Quickly match up with a random partner and enjoy co-op play. What I'm actually going to do, I am going to end the game and I will start over so that it can connect online, because I did turn it on when I before actually turned it up, or before it actually started up. Obviously when I went away, you guys saw it. I don't know why I'm actually explaining that, like, you guys, like, that didn't happen in the video, but I would like to do this online and actually play with somebody. I think that would be really fun. Plus, it would be my first co-op experience with the game, because, of course, I went through this whole campaign single player. Not that I could do multiplayer anyway, because whoever did the port took out co-op, which really sucks. So, hate that. And this is interesting, just even having this as a thing. I really love that, actually. Like, it just starts off as, like, a character. Oh, it has my little symbol up there, too. From my ResidentEvil.net thing. Stick with Claire. Okay, so everyone has their own level as well. Okay. So we're set up to the daily. Normal, defeat the enemies, zero cost. I'm gonna defeat the enemies, and I can only do it with Hunk. Why not? Is it gonna? I'm wondering if it's gonna switch me automatically. Okay, I guess not. Get Hunk, the classic. Oh, he has all his spaces open. That's pretty cool. Oh, that might be because Hunk was actually one of the downloadable characters, I believe. I think Hunk and Wesker. Oh, they put Albert. Oh, gross. I don't know why they put Albert instead of Wesker. Everybody calls him Wesker. Albert. Like, who is Albert? It's like, that's not a villain. That's a guy. Albert. Let's do this. Albert. What the heck? That doesn't even make sense. Why would they put Albert? That's gross. Yep, Resident Evil 6. Holy crap. That is actually very cool. Ooh, now I know. Not that that's what I was trying to do. I was trying to hit the other one anyway, but, you know, whatever. He always has the coolest freaking thing. I wonder if the blade is there. Shoot, dude, dang. All right. Back off. Okay, so they took out the blades, because there's a blade here if you're actually playing Resident Evil 6, for those of you who haven't. Running at me, eh? Get the feeling that there's gonna be someone behind me. I'm gonna have to remember that that's his thing, but it's like, it doesn't matter that it is, or whether it is or isn't, because I can't hit multiple people at one time, so it's like, eh. That is a slick little dash attack. The dog. I love how they still manage to keep the dog shooting animations remain the same to this day from the original game. Every time you shoot a dog, they'll like fly across, like they're running at you, just like poom, and they'll just like fly off screen and stuff. They just fly so far away, it's really funny. And they still kept that alive. If there's one thing they've kept alive, it's that. Okay. So they blocked this off too. This is cool. I really like this. Alright, that was a total failure. That didn't work like I thought it would. fair enough. Well, I already got the achievement, it doesn't matter at this point. Put myself on enough. I'm in the face. Boom. Coming at me. Out of my house. So, a lot of these, yeah, they bumped up this whole section. Alright, so in that area right there, it's a lot of... See? Profit just... Wow, I suck. That was just full on sad. That was incredibly. That was an incredibly sad display of strength. Or skill, not really strength. Okay, block that off. Those are just stairs that lead to the next area, so I guess they just kinda. That worked. That's pretty cool. These guys. They look exactly like the ones from Resident Evil 6, actually. They definitely have. In the catacomb area. Oddly enough. Well, I got them. They have, they definitely have zombies that look just like that. They're like old school zombies. They kind of look like they were in armor a bit. Out of here, oh crap. Got 10 more to go. Probably get up beforehand. Alright. They're moving a little slow now, so I'm just gonna go at them and get rid of these guys. I don't even know what he's doing. Ooh, whatever that is, I want it. Dang. I wonder if those froze them or if they were gonna explode. I was curious because they're blue and not red, which is an actual color for the explosives. Okay. Blow these guys away. Oh, okay. Alright, thank you, computer. Alright, sorry about that. I don't know why the heck that just happened. That was weird. Not sure why that happened at all. Actually, let me go back really quick. No, it's still recording. Okay, had to make sure it was at least still recording. I'm not sure what the case was there. That was definitely weird, but I don't know. I really don't know. I didn't push anything. Like, there's nothing on my sitting on top of the keyboard or anything weird. That was something though. Showstopper. They got me. Impairment frozen. A frozen character will be unable to move. Wow. What a shock. I just realized I have my mic. My mic is a little bit sideways. I just realized that. It's like off to the side. Tiny bit. Life crystals are used for respawning when you run out of health on a mission. Upon responding, your health and skill usage will be... fully restored. Responding is not allowed in certain missions. Red and blue life crystals. There are two varieties of life crystals, red and blue. Both have the same functionality, but blue will be used first. I'm assuming blue uses less. You will receive blue life crystals. You will receive a fixed amount from the start, and you can gain more as rewards from daily missions. These can be red crystals can be purchased from the online store, the black phone in the vestibule. Huh. Cool. Okay, so we're gonna go. I kind of want to switch now because he has the option to use, you know, all his weapons, but we'll go back to Claire for sure. Actually. Yeah, so every. Well, there's a. Okay. Clear the campaign, clear raid mode, obtain 20 or more completion medallions. 90. Jeez. Alright, so I beat the campaign. I have to clear raid mode, so I'm assuming that means just do normal missions. She kind of looks like Hunnigan from Resident Evil 4 and 6 in this picture a little bit, and it's really because of her hair and glasses. Hunnigan is a black woman though, so that's literally it. It's just because they have glasses and the long hair, and that's it. Also, she's got like crazy cleavage in that shirt, which is weird. It's him looking like a beat up janitor. This guy in this, you know, tank top. Albert, this doesn't make sense. Evgeny, that's cool. And Neil, the traitor. Alright, we'll go back to Claire. Whoops. And I'm going to attempt to do a co-op mission. Event mission sequence during limited time period. Well, let's do this. New. I highly doubt that the matchmaking is really going to find someone that's only level 2, but it is possible. I don't know, I'm pretty sure I mentioned this last time, but Resident Evil recently celebrated its 20th anniversary. So that's also, I'm not sure, I don't know if I'm going to do this or not, but currently, like, once it became the 20th anniversary, I switched my icon to the Biohazard, you know, 20th anniversary thing. And I'm kind of debating whether or not I'm going to leave that as my little icon for like the rest of the year, because it is my favorite franchise and this is the 20th anniversary. I didn't even think of it to do it until it actually happened. Like, I could have done, you know, I could have started it this year and just left that as my thing, which at this point I don't think would matter too much. It's not like people, you know, I don't have so many subscribers, it's like it blows people's minds if I switch my avatar. So I can still kind of do that and just play around with that idea if I want to. And I do that anyway for certain stuff. I did it for Ruby Volume 3, which I did it for a certain reason, which I won't spoil. And I don't think I'm going to find anybody, which is really sad. Yeah. But I'm debating whether or not I'm going to do that. So how many missions? Jeez, there are a buttload of missions. All right. Oh, crap. There are even more missions than I thought there were. So we have our normal missions, the hard missions, and then the very hard missions. And most of these have, what is it, 9? Yeah, so that's 9. So this one actually has a full-on 10, which is interesting. It has the Omega symbol, which I'm very curious about that one. And it's weird that they would do it this way instead of just having these moved up here and just having empty spaces there and then having the Omega down here. And so the 9s go across right here and then just the Omega goes down one, but, you know. Weird, little weird, that's all. So, fork, okay, whatever. What? As in, okay, let's do that. Oh, okay. Crap, that is a buttload more missions than I was thinking. I didn't even realize it was like that when I first started it, where it was 1-1 and it goes to 1-5. So that is a million missions. Resident Evil 6 as well. This is actually really awesome. This is really cool. Just the idea behind this and them doing things this way. Oh, okay. Gotcha. I'm kind of freaked out that they're going to throw in some of the Resident Evil 6 creatures, but I highly doubt it. Ooh, get out of here. In Resident Evil 6, in this specific area, there are, like these mutated scorpion-like figures. So it would be very interesting if one of those bad boys just kind of popped out on me out of nowhere and just started running down the hallway. Not exactly something I'm prepared for. So to my right. Come on. Oh. I'm sure they'll chase me down. They really want to take me down. I'm like, is he dead or whoa? Get out of here. Oh, assault rifle. I guess he would only affect me. I like the burn ones better because when I kill them, they blow up and affect me. Yeah, well, they're... Ah! Nice one, nice one. Give him that. Freaking maze. It's just like this in Resident Evil 6 too. And it's even crazier because you're trying to chase down these things. It's actually one of my least favorite parts of the game, actually. I guess. But it's one of my least favorite parts because you're trying to chase this thing down, and as you could probably imagine, a giant scorpion is not, you know, anything as like crazy kickback. Well, yeah, you're trying to chase down this freaking giant scorpion, and with all its legs, it's moving like crazy. Like, it's running around all over the place. And it's not easy to really come across. It's trying to avoid you the whole time. So, it does not tend to be easy playing this section of the game. And you even have AI helping you. Like, it's... You know, every campaign has the two characters, but in that specific section... Oh, come on. That just stuck his arms out. So, like, during that specific section... Let's do this, just have some fun. Get out of my face. But in that section, sorry, I keep getting distracted by all the other zombies. But it's not just you and your AI partner. Like, there are a couple of different AI things in there, if I remember correctly. Taller than the other ones. I think it was. Admittedly, I'm actually... Yeah, they are taller. Admittedly, I'm actually a bit excited to get to the harder difficulties. Because right now, of course, it's, you know, it's level 2. But I've been playing Resident Evil for long enough. Even, you know, including this style of Resident Evil game, so... So I'm a bit adept at, you know, taking them down. Even when I'm about to screw up and, you know, they're like running right at me. So that should definitely be enough for this area. And that's... Oh, okay, so no, it's just the one area itself. Because I was about to say... I guess that makes sense, yeah, because this is... This is inside of a hotel. I'm probably going to just explain where every level is. For anyone who doesn't know, where these levels take place inside of Resident Evil 6. So, sorry if you have played all of 6 and you know exactly where all these sections are, but... For anyone who doesn't, you know, I'm going to explain where they take place in the game. And this is during Chris's campaign. And in 6, Chris is in the army. Like, he's the leader of, like, his own unit within the BSAA. It was not technically the army. But, you know, he's in, like, his own unit of the BSAA. And so he's leading a squad through this hotel, which is in China. It's in a fake place. A big country in China. Alright. Forgot you can't just swipe and destroy them. But it takes place in this fake country in China, and the hotel is basically just getting destroyed. Like, it's falling apart. There are monsters in there. You're supposed to, like, rescue, like, these delegates or something like that, I believe. I like the first assault rifle better. It looks more like an actual assault rifle. I can't think of the name I'm looking for, but just an assault rifle. The second one is, of course, an AK-47 style assault rifle, but I like the more military style ones. They seem to have a slightly more precision. If you meet the right conditions when clearing a mission, you will earn a medallion. There are 5 types of medallions in all, and you can earn up to 5 of them per mission. Unlocking gauntlets. Medallions are needed to unlock new gauntlets. The gauntlet list on the deployment screen shows the number of medallions needed to unlock gauntlets. 1. Earned when you clear a mission. Earned by clearing a mission at or below the recommended level. Earned when you clear a mission without using herbs. Earned if you defeat all enemies within a mission. The hardest medallion to earn. You must earn all of the other medallions at the same time to get this one. Earning medallions. You can earn the clear medallion just by clearing the mission. If you're low on medallions, the fastest way to earn more is to play missions you haven't cleared yet. If you already cleared all the mission, you've already earned all the clear mission medallions, you still need more, try earning the no herb medallions or genocide medallions with high level characters. If you want to earn even more medallions, you'll have to go for the completion medallions, which require a high level of skill to earn. You have to use a character whose level is at or lower than the recommended level and defeat all enemies without using any herbs. This makes even easy early missions seem difficult. You can make things easier by upgrading your weapons and skills, since these don't affect your character level. If you're still having a hard time, take a break and try another mission. Weird that that wasn't introduced or, you know, like, talked about after I beat, like, the very first mission, because it's not like I didn't get, you know, medallions on that one. First. Yay. Defeat the enemies. See if there's one other daily mission we got. Actually, let's switch real quick. Let's go with random cleavage lady. I don't even know who she is in the story. I don't remember this character whatsoever. But she does. Oh, I guess I just get all the weapons in general. I get whatever I choose. I'll go with the shotgun for her. Dang, she has like a buttload of skills though. She's actually a pretty great character. Her passive skills: increased recovery speed to 150%. If your health is at 50% or above when you receive a killing blow, you will survive with 1 point of health. Heal under any circumstances, that's actually pretty good. Attack with gestures, that's pretty good. She's actually got some major skills, random lady. I really don't remember who this woman is from the story. Also, how do I... Oh, I probably can't. Probably can't do the gestures until I'm in-game. Level 100 weapons can be upgraded beyond their limits. Depending on how long this takes, this might be my last one. Crit creepy. This makes me think of Alan Wake with all these logs. Oh, crap. I wasn't expecting that. All right. Everywhere but the place that counts. Glad it's walking super slow. Oh god. What the heck is she? I'm really gonna have to replay this game because I do not remember who this woman Gina is at all. Yeah, odds are I'm not gonna be getting through this without using an herb. Plus there are 30 enemies. I definitely thought that was going to be an item for me. Alright. Yeah, so this... I feel like this will end up being my last one. This seems like it will definitely take the last bit of time. Seriously? Everywhere but where I shoot. Like the last place every time. Ah, finally. Yeah. Ah, crap. Wasn't counting. Ooh. That was a very fortunate shot because I definitely wasn't prepared yet. Much like I don't believe I'm prepared to take on all these things, wherever they are. I guess I can't get past here. Oh, you guys are just zombies. Weak sauce. Oh, so they can freeze them. That is very good to know. What is that? Ah, come on. What's the deal with this thing? And I got this guy on the ground crawling at me. I'm like, something's off here. That's only 12 out of 30 enemies. Jeez, I still got a long way to go. Whoa, hey! Dang. Most likely I won't end up going back for those, so I won't waste the ammo. Ooh. Thought for sure I'd begin to kick on that guy. I just wasn't gonna. Ah, jeez. Whoa, hey! Alright. Yeah, maybe I will just flat out go back for him. Save myself. What the heck? Now they're spitting out poison on me. way too close, but definitely, definitely worth it. I have to get the heck out of here. Definitely glad I used the shotgun now. Already back at full ammo. Go towards the light. What? No way. It's impervious from the front. Alright, that's... That'll be a challenge to say the least. Okay, that's what I was hoping for. And I got exactly what I wanted out of that. You know what? That was good enough. Get out of here. You get out of here as well. Crap, I don't know where that even just came from. Okay, maybe still needed a second stab. Thank you. Oh, BS. Can shoot it through the shield. Okay, I'm so confused. I guess it just takes way less damage. I didn't even realize I could shoot like that. That was definitely a good challenge. And I will make this my last one. So, nice successful ending with a nice extra 20 or so seconds. I'll probably end up going over that just doing the outro. But this was fun. That was definitely fun. Enjoyed that for sure. I wish I could have played with someone online, but I know, especially considering the time of this game, how old it is. I know it's probably unlikely that it'll really I'll be able to easily find someone to play with. And I don't know if I ever even finished this thought, but when I was looking online and I was mentioning it might be possible that I find someone, it's because with the 20th anniversary thing, yeah, I went into like my logo stuff. The reason I brought up the 20th anniversary stuff is because, who is this woman? Gina. It's because with the 20th anniversary thing, Steam did a huge sale on like all the Resident Evil games. So this was on sale for like a couple of bucks or something like that. I'm not sure if it was the first episode. It was like $2, so I'm pretty sure it was just for the first episode. But all of the games were on sale. I bought Operation Raccoon City, which, you know, has very, very mixed views, but it was like $8 for the entire game plus all the DLC, and I always wanted to get it for consoles because I thought it'd be easier that way, and I know it would be if I went to play online, and apparently it'll be even easier just to play it because apparently the Games for Windows Live thing has an issue. But I was like, it's on sale for $30 to $8, and I was like, I kind of have to just get it this way, and it has, you know, all the DLC. Same reason I normally get most games if they're on sale, if I wanted them. It's like I get everything plus DLC way cheaper than I could possibly find it. So did the same thing. I'm really trying to figure out who this woman is. I don't remember her at all, but oh well. But I don't know, maybe I'll be able to find somebody at some point. I would really love to. That would be very cool if I could. It's good, like a nice random match. Oh well, it doesn't matter. I probably won't find anybody anyway. But this was pretty cool. Like I said, I enjoyed, as far as the two extra episodes, I like Little Miss a little bit better because it was kind of puzzle style. It was creepy, and you know, it was all these, you know, old areas, but they had a slightly new aesthetic to them with the weird dream sort of thing that they had going with the mist and the little particles floating around. And it's still really weird because it was almost, you know, it's like its own story as an episode, but it was still really weird because it's like, okay, clearly she developed the ability to see the monsters and, you know, stuff like that after that happened, but it was still a weird thing, just the fact that she even went through it, and it's just like, you know, she was seeing this dark version of herself, which was clearly meant to be Alex, you know, in her mind, but it was still really weird. It was just like, and technically Natalia is Alex with the clone stuff, but it was just really weird. I was like, okay, so she was actually out in the world, but somehow, despite her not being in the machine, everything that Alex was doing was still working on her until, I don't know if it was a distance thing or what. That's like the weird thing about it. It's like she was clearly in the machine and she got out, and she was seeing this version of herself that wasn't actually there because it was Alex trying to manipulate her. And then I guess because she reached the goal, like her point, Alex's point was to let, you know, have Natalia let her in so that she, I guess she could fully take control of the perfect clone. And ultimately it all kind of falls apart and it doesn't work mentally, but it was weird that she could even do that, because that type of thing didn't show up in the main game where she had some sort of like mind control over her or anything like that. And it was just like full control from one end of the island to the edge of the island, still under this weird mental control. And then she finally reached like this mental goal, I guess in her own head she made it herself, and you know, Alex didn't like that, and that's why it didn't work. But it was still weird just the way it ended. It was like, so she wasn't in the machine, but all that stuff was happening because of the machine slash some weird sort of telepathy leftover stuff or something. It was weird. So it's still really weird how they kind of structured the ending of that. And it's just like, poof, she's not in the machine at all. And it wasn't even in her head, which I thought would have been a much better answer, maybe. And maybe it was, I guess, in a way, I guess it was all in her head. And it was the part of Alex inside of her head that she was supposed to defeat. And maybe she, you know, she defeated it. Excuse me, but it was just weird. So I guess that's how it is, that she defeated that part of Alex that was still within her mind. And it was sort of like a program type of thing where she tells her, like, you know, next time you won't see me coming. And it was meant to be like a full-on program inside of her own head. And it was a part of Alex that could consciously do its own thing until Natalia reached a certain point where she kind of broke free of that bond. So I'm adding a lot in there. That's what I'm just assuming it is. But it was just kind of a weird way to do it. But I still enjoyed it more, a little bit more than the other episode, just because of how different it was and the no weapon aspect of it. Not even bricks. I couldn't even use bricks to distract them. I could only use smoke screens to actually get past them, and that was it. So certainly enjoyed that. I'm enjoying raid mode so far. I would love to be able to play with somebody. If you guys have this on Steam, obviously I'm Invisible Katana on Steam, and I'd like to play with you guys if you're interested. And I will go through, and I don't know, I'm not sure when I'll get back to this. I might do an episode sometime soon, you know, near the time of me doing this one. I really have no idea, especially considering the style that the episodes would be. It would really just be raid mode, so it wouldn't be, you know, it's not even the same as Mercenaries mode, where you're on like a time constraint, but every kill gets you more time, and so it's like a bit of a challenge. It's still a challenge, but it's just kill the enemies and that's it. So it's, you know, it takes out that time factor. It's just kill these enemies and that's it. The enemies get tougher and that's the challenge, but for the most part, you know, it kind of comes out as the same a little bit. So I don't know. Why does this guy get 3? What's this skill he's got? Ready the drill and push forward with violent force. Okay, does he get the drill? Oh, okay, interesting. Shotgun master, improves shotgun functionality, blocks 150 points of damage, shield automatically regenerates. That's actually a really cool passive skill. I might end up using him pretty soon. But yeah, this was fun though. I definitely gracias. Enjoyed this.
Sorry, gracias.
Well, that's pretty cool. The just the random motion ones are just funny though. It's just the way he's shaking so violently is what makes that so incredibly funny to me. Like, that's just silly. I never would have expected that to be in Resident Evil game. It's just funny that they actually went the gesture route. Especially, that's like just the weirdest thing. That's like one of the zombies coming at me, honestly. I mean, that's like the things that I have to shoot to, you know, discover the bulb. That's how they move. They're all jittery and stuff. And that's what they put for the robot. That's like the most... That's the fastest moving robot I've ever seen. And as the camera goes off, I'll put it on one last time to officially do this outro. I didn't even realize that it was actually at the end. I forgot that I have my shorter timer, so it goes off a little bit more. But I definitely want to thank you guys for joining me for this episode. Like I said, I don't really know when I'm going to get back to the main thing, or get back to the game in general. But I don't know, I'm definitely looking forward to doing it. Odds are, I may not get back to this for quite some time, and a big part of that is going to be just because it really would only be raid mode. Like I said, I may or may not do that, but I really don't know. I will definitely get back to it for sure sometime over the summer, because I'm going through, and I've mentioned this already, but when I do the whole franchise, I'm going to do this. I don't know if I'll include raid mode in that. I might do the bonus stages of all the different games as well, just to go through them all. But I'll definitely at least get back to the main campaign. And, that's really awesome. Okay, so she's from Revelations 1, and so is she. That is actually very cool. Oh, Lady Hunk. Also, if I remember right, they added Lady Hunk from Revelations 1 as well. So that's actually really cool. So Gina can become all these different characters. Also, busty for no good reason character right there. See, just nice regular character. She's got the aviator cap on, but, you know, whatever. Lady Hunk. Okay, so that's it. Now I'm super curious who has costumes and who doesn't, because I never expected her to have a costume thing on there. So now I feel like I gotta go through all of these. Oh! Okay, that's actually pretty cool. We get Mutant Pedro. Also didn't realize those were eyeballs on him. This is going way beyond what I was expecting. I didn't think that there would be costumes to change. Ooh. Framework completion medallions. Okay. Oh, that's pretty awesome. I'm gonna go with that when I do it. And then Moira has just the one. Oh, okay. Clear gauntlet 8 on hard or higher. Okay. And then it's like her sexy devil ninja thing going on. I don't really know what that is, but it's cool. Whatever. It still has the I like the fact that it keeps the color scheme of the pink and the black, so that's pretty cool. But she also has a katana, which is super awesome. But thank you guys for joining me. I don't know, like I said, when I'm gonna get back to this. I might get back to it sooner now that I know all the costumes are in here, just to play around with different costume ideas and stuff like that, because that's actually pretty cool. She just gets one weapon. Dang. To level 5, huh? So I'll do that with the katana. Oh yeah, I don't remember if I did this on the channel or if I just saw it or what, but I forgot she had the actual like tattoos and stuff, which is really cool. But I really like this outfit, aside, you know the whole skin thing is whatever, but I actually like this. I think it would look super cool if that was just a normal jacket that went down. It is funny that it's like a hoodie and full-on sleeves, and then it's just like, let's have the boobs breathe or something. So that's kind of funny. And of course she's got like short shorts on and the I guess knee-high socks or thigh-high socks, whatever, I don't know, I don't wear them. But she's got a katana and the cool devil point hoodie is sweet. Plus the hair color changes, which I actually think is really awesome. But I'm gonna officially end this here because I'm just rambling now and looking at random crap that means nothing. But thank you guys for joining me. Of course, if you guys have any comments, please put them down in the comment section below. And I'm going to get to this at some point. I'll probably get to this before I end up going through the whole franchise all over again. I probably will be doing raid mode a couple more, maybe one more episode, because with an hour worth of raid, that's probably enough to kind of cover on the channel. But thank you guys for joining me, and, you know, please join me in the next part.